good evening, everybody.
Exactly. I'm the chairman of the Chair in Charge Foundation and CEO of a startup called eMobilify. I'm based in Germany. The foundation is based here in Switzerland. We have one major challenge in EV charging, and that's so-called roaming. So we have 500 charge point operators in Germany, 500 mobility service providers, 600 DSOs, and they all need to communicate with each other. And we saw the use case outside. We have currently first solutions, which are centralized roaming platforms, but they have also kind of the dangers of centralized platforms. They are expensive, there's a monopoly, you have the danger of a lock-in, etc. And this leads to real-life problems. So you as an EV driver, you need different apps, RFID cards to really access all the charge points nowadays. And we will see in the near future huge problems in the energy system. So we all we have this concurrent charging, people coming at home at 6. And if we do not have a digital layer who can facilitate smart charging, we'll face serious problems in the power grid. So that is what we are solving. We are doing this already for 3.5 years. We started as an Innogy spin-off. We learned a lot about corporate spin-off structures. So I have a 10-year corporate background with ENBW, RWE, Innogy. We learned the challenges of spin-offs. We also learned that the idea was perceived very well by all the partners, but they didn't like that it was owned by Innogy. That was the major reason why we set up a foundation in Switzerland in order to create a governance of a totally independent entity. And how it basically works is, in the beginning, we also tried to solve everything with blockchain. So our very first approach from an architecture perspective was 100% blockchain. We then realized that it's not the most efficient way on doing this. And now we found a very, I would say, very neat architecture, which is very well perceived in the EV domain, which is we have a so-called open charging network and OCN clients, which are kind of comparable to email clients. All the parties can download them. And these clients communicate with each other, and you can host either your own client or you can connect to another client, and that is fully open source. And with this, we have the connectivity layer as a fully open source non-profit infrastructure layer, which is currently a commercial model, and we just don't believe that it works. So that is kind of the TCP IP logic. We still work with blockchain on two sides. One is the registry of all these participants, which is stored in a smart contract. And the other one is we are still working with stablecoins. We were the first ones in Germany who had a stablecoin already live 3 years ago. We currently do a large field pilot with Innogy, 1,500 public charge points, 50 test customers. Over 3 months, they can charge with stablecoins from MakerDAO. It is just that we needed to accept over the last 3 years, stablecoins will not come in the next 2 to 3 years. So none of the corporates we work with will take DAI into their hands. So that is why we are also, from a pragmatic go-to-market approach, we are now also offering an e-money solution, which is going live beginning of next year. Yeah, as already said, we are a non-profit organization. We have some strong supporters. Funnily enough, a lot of the partners we work with are also shareholders of the central platform. So we see that in e-mobility, everything is currently moving and nobody really knows where it's ending. And that's obviously a quite nice window of opportunity for us as a startup. We are going live, by the way, also with the OCN already in January, February now. So I think we are one of the probably most advanced in this decentralized world as we are now beyond the POC phase and we are really going live with more than 1,000 charge points. We did a great collaboration with Kilian and the team. So we took the general framework on governance and applied it to Share in Charge in our very practical experiences. It's worth a read. You find that on Medium. There are 6 articles about governance and what are the challenges. And I can tell you there are a lot of challenges. And I brought kind of 2 hypotheses to start also into the discussion, which is my learning. And I also started, besides Share in Charge, I also initiated OMOS, Open Mobility System, together with Fraunhofer Institute, which is kind of, for the time being, a little bit on hold with a lot of mobility companies where I learned a lot about it. And the first one is, I think we were all so excited in the course of the last years. So we were kind of a holiday flirt. So everybody was so excited about blockchain and consortia and governance that we somehow forgot to ask the real relevant question in every relationship. So what can we offer and what do we want to get out of it? And that sounds very trivial, but the big challenge here is that we obviously still do not know what exactly we can get out of it. So because it's cutting-edge technology and there's so much new stuff going on, we are just not 100% sure what our business model will look like. And that's obviously a huge challenge if you want to go into a relationship with another person or another company. If you're not 100% sure about what you want to get out of it and what you can offer, that's quite challenging. And the second one is, I hear a lot about, we share the same vision, and that's great to hear. We all understand the problem of the platforms. It is just what our experience, especially with large companies, is somehow like Animal Farm. So all animals are equals, but some animals are more equal than others. So always, if it becomes very tangible, very concrete, we often have this experience that some companies want to be a little bit more clever than the other. And to really this real open collaboration, I still think is one of the major challenges in this whole domain. Thank you very much.
Thanks very much.